Good afternoon. First of all, I want to thank all of you for assisting to this presentation. I will talk about modeling quantum circuits with UML. And my name is Luis Jiménez Navajas, and I belong to both the Quantum Team and the LARCOS Research Group, from the University of Castilla-La Mancha. A Quantum is a research, development, consulting and services group in the fields of quantum software engineering and programming, co-formed by Alhambra and Grupo LARCOS. As we all know, almost every day there are relevant news about quantum computing in different and important newspapers or web pages, like Bloomberg or the Business Insiders. We can see this slide. China with ambitious goals in 5-year plan, how quantum computing could transform the future, and Israel allocating $60 million to build the first quantum computer. We can conclude that there is a huge expectation of this new paradigm and a high investment for taking advantage of it. So, in a future, the different companies will implement in one way or another quantum algorithms in their systems for taking advantage of its computational power. However, the organizations cannot make a transition toward quantum computing discarding their actual systems. This is because of the classical system are still useful for the companies as they may end mission-critical knowledge. Also, quantum failed operations won't make sense, as the computational gain acquired will be low compared to the cost that the implementation requires. Our predictions about how the different organizations will take advantage of this paradigm will be through hybrid systems, where the companies will migrate some of their mission-critical functionalities to quantum software, while other new functionalities are still implemented in the classical software. This approach will transform the classical information systems into hybrid information systems. The development of quantum or hybrid information systems cannot simply consist of a collection of code modules, but it should rather follow a whole life cycle. It does not matter how long the life cycle is, since what is certain is that the quantum software must be designed at some point. Software design defines the architecture, system elements, interfaces and other characteristics of the system in order to accomplish goals using a set of primitive components, and it's subject to constraints. UML can help by gathering, analyzing software requirements and incorporating them into a programming design in a technology and methodology independent. This will make it possible to additionally use UML with hybrid information systems. Although other modeling languages can be used to design software, we believe that the usage of UML in quantum software engineering will have several advantages. First, the different perspective, as UML provides many different diagrams or models to look at the system from various perspectives or concerns. Then the design validation, the aforementioned perspectives, allow UML to help quantum software engineers to communicate, explore potential design, and validate the architecture design of the software. The best practices UML represents a collection of the best engineering practices that have been proved successful in the modeling of large complex systems. These practices could consequently be applied in the quantum hybrid information systems. Structure design as UML modeling makes it easier to structure software as a collection of self-contained modules or components. This enables the reuse of code, scalability, and robustness. The tooling, since UML is a widely adopted ISO/IEC standard, most of the design and modeling tools support it. One of the primary goals of the UML is to advance the state of industry by enabling object visual modeling tools. The software modernization UML is not only used for design target hybrid information systems that will be implemented by forward engineering. UML models can also be generated by reverse engineering tools that analyze existing software, for example, in order to migrate or modernize software toward hybrid information systems. Despite the advantages mentioned, UML needs to be adopted in order to capture all the new semantics and building blocks involved in quantum software. As it was defined on the basis of the metal object facility, which is a metamodel, UML is therefore a metamodel that is used to define different UML models. and its extension consequently consist of extending the metamodel. It is possible to extend it by principally following three different approaches. First, a new instance of the meta-object facility model. This approach consists of creating a completely new metamodel based on the meta-loader facility. The result of this heavyweight approach is a new domain-specific modeling language. Second, the derivation of a new UML metamodel. This approach adds a new metamodel element to the existing one. As occurs with the first approach, it is a different metamodel, but at least consider it the original UML model as it is. And the last one, the UML profile. This is a lightweight extension approach that it is based on the UML built-in extension mechanism, which is the UML profiling. UML profiles are created as a set of stereotypes, tags, values, and constraints defined for some of the existing UML elements. These three approaches have various pros and cons. The expressiveness of the two first approaches is powerful, since conformity with UML is not necessary, particularly in the case of approach of the first approach. Despite the fact that the expressiveness of UML profile is limited, standardization and conformance are better, since the extension is fully compliant with UML. This advantage is a key aspect as regards the usage of the defined profile with existing UML modeling tools. Moreover, it is easier to maintain extensions that have been defined as UML profiles, since the associated modeling tools do not need to be adjusted after each change, as occurs with the domain-specific modeling tools. And in fact, they usually end up with an overloaded and imprecise language. The aforementioned advantages led us to believe that the UML profile is the best way in which to define the UML extension for quantum information systems. This is the preliminary UML profile design in order to represent the quantum programs as activity diagrams by using a graphical notation like the employed by quantum circuits. It should be noted that a broader UML profile will be defined for the representation of not only quantum circuits, but also the analysis and design concerns of hybrid information systems. The UML profile consists of six stereotypes with which to add the new semantic related to quantum circuits. The quantum circuits, qubit, quantum gate, control qubit, measure, and reset. The left-hand side shows an excerpt of the UML metamodel employed to represent UML activity diagrams. The intuitive idea behind representing quantum circuits with UML activity diagrams is that each algorithm is represented with a single compound activity with stereotyped quantum circuits. The entire circuit is, therefore, defined in this activity, and the compound activity can be reused in other circuits, as occurs in quantum programming. The various activity partitions, graphically represented as horizontal swim lanes, can be defined in the parent activity by employing the qubit stereotype. The circuit has as many activity partitions as different qubits used in algorithms. All the different quantum gates applied in the circuits are, therefore, represented as action elements and are placed in their respective swim lane, according to the qubit under which the gate is applied or controlled. On the one hand, ordinary quantum gates, such as Hadamard or Pauli, are represented as scale operation action plus the quantum gate stereotype. On the other, conditional gates are represented with multiple action elements. The controlled qubits are represented with sensational action elements with the stereotype control qubits, while the gate applied is represented with a counter element, accept element action plus the quantum gate stereotype. Additionally, in order to add the semantic concerning the relationship between the control qubits, various constraints elements are established between the action elements involved. In order to illustrate how the quantum UML profile is applied, and to demonstrate its applicability, I will provide a running example by using the teleportation algorithm. This algorithm supports quantum teleportation, a technique used to transfer quantum information from source to destination by employing entangled states. In this example, Q0 is the qubit that represents the message to be sent. Q1 is an auxiliary qubit, and Q2 is the target qubit that will receive the information coded in Q0. In this example, Q0 is not initialized to make the sample more trivial. After the application of the quantum UML profile, the activity diagram will look like this. The whole circuit is enclosed in a composed activity with the respective stereotype, therefore has three horizontal activity partitions, one for each qubit. The quantum gates and measure are then placed as action elements in the same position as in the original quantum circuit. One interesting aspect of the quantum circuit represented with UML is that the measures can be connected with data stores node that represent classical values after a qubit is measured. Other ordinary UML elements outside the whole circuit could be connected with elements of the quantum circuits in order to define relationships with classical elements. In this slide, we can see clearly how each of the elements of the teleportation algorithm are represented in the activity diagram. With regard to the quantum gates C0 and CZ, these are modeled with pairs of send signal action and accept event action, connected by a restriction edge, together with the stereotypes control qubit and quantum gate, while the Hadamard gate is represented as an action element. The execution flow of the circuit in UML is explicitly represented through the use of control flow elements from the initial node to the activity final node through all the quantum gates. This explicit flow contrasts with the original quantum circuits, in which the execution flow is implicit, which has some advantages in some cases, such as the optimization of the quantum algorithms, during which the specific order of the quantum gates may be of interest. Although several quantum circuit notation with which to graphically represent quantum algorithms already exist, the UML adds a similar notation that is understood by the main role players in the quantum software engineering field, and which is available in many existing modeling tools. In fact, the approach followed in this research consists of a lightweight extension based on a UML profile, the built-in extension mechanism provided by UML. Unlike other heavyweight extension mechanisms, we believe the quantum UML profile has two clear advantages. First, the reuse of existing UML modeling tools, and the integration with other standard UML elements, which is useful as regards representing hybrid information systems. The example shown previously demonstrated the potential for employing the quantum UML profile in the designing of hybrid information systems, and also it could make more unstable the development of quantum algorithms, helping as a basis for future developments. This presentation proposes the UML extension as part of more extensive long-term research devoted to providing a quantum UML profile that will cover other viewpoints and aspects of the analysis and design of hybrid information systems. For example, use case, class, sequence, component, and deployment diagrams will be extended with the quantum UML profile, and our future research line will compromise precisely this. As future works, the implementation of more complex algorithms like the quantum Fourier or quantum Fourier transformation or phase estimation will be made in order to check the applicability of the UML activity diagrams for that purpose. That was all, and if you have any questions, you can start making them.